Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Techie Sugan. In this video, we are going to learn about looping statements in Python. Let us understand what is the use of looping statement and how we are going to implement it. Whenever I mean that programming, how the program executes? Program executes in a sequential manner where the first statement executes, next second line and it goes on. Whenever the situation arises, you want certain block of code to be executed multiple times. I'll go with this looping statement. How does this looping executes in Python? This for loop act as your iterator in Python. What is iterator? Iterator is nothing but accessing a sequential element, either starting from 1 to 100 or 1 to 1000 or 1 to 10. Accessing sequential element. So by using this looping, I can able to access a sequential element which act as an iterator. Or this loop is used for accessing an iterable item. Whenever I mean that iterable item, it might be either a string or a list or a dictionary or a tuple, where the elements inside this iterable item can be accessed by using this looping. And in case of Python, there are two types of looping statement. One is for loop and other is your while loop. Let us see with the syntax of each and everything. First, we'll move on to for loop. The syntax of a for loop is for iterator variable. This variable is a user defined variable in sequence. This is the syntax, and whatever the block of code you want to be repeated, you will be writing inside this by giving an indentation space. This is the syntax of for loop. And other syntax, there is one more syntax, or I can write in a other manner, which is nothing but writing else part for your for loop. For iterable variable in sequence followed by the statements of your for loop, else if this condition become false, I want a certain other code to be executed, I'll be writing in a else part. This else is not a mandatory one, it is an optional one. Clear? Now let us understand what is this sequence, what you are going to give here. This sequence is nothing but in this part I can give a function called range. This range is nothing but, as I told you, that this particular looping act as a iterable in the sense accessing a range of value. This range of value is accessed by using a function called range. This function is a predefined function where this function accepts three parameters. First parameter is a starting parameter, and second parameter is an ending parameter, and the last parameter is a step parameter. For each and every iteration, how many steps you want to move, either one step or two step or three step. This is the three parameter of your range operator. And this range is nothing but, if you are aware about some other programming language, you might learn about the for loop. What is the syntax of for loop there? For initialization, condition, followed by increment. The same thing I have mentioned here. For initialization is nothing but your start, and condition part is for termination. I will mention in case of other programming. Here it's nothing but end, and step is nothing but there we'll see with increment, and the here I'll name it as a step value. And next, if I have given three parameter here, whether these three parameters are mandatory one or optional one. Among these three, where the n parameter is a mandatory one, where this end is a mandatory one, and if this start, if you know the starting point of your iteration, you are going to mention the start value there. If you doesn't know, just leave it as, don't give it, leave it. So what happens there? It start with zero value. So this start is an optional one. If you are not giving a start value, it start with zeros. Clear? And next, and end value is a mandatory one. And last parameter is a step value, and this step is also not a mandatory one. Step is also an optional one, where step value by default is increment by 1. For each and every iteration, it will increment by 1. I hope so you are clear. Where the start value start with 0 whenever it is not given. Whenever it is given, it start with a particular value. And where the end value will terminate at the position where you are given. I mean that if the end value is given as 5, it terminates in the 4th position. It never goes to till 5, it terminates by the 4th position. I will explain you when you are seeing with the program. And next is step value. Step value is nothing but for each and every iteration, what is the step value you are going to use it. Let us have a simple example for it. I will open ideally. By keeping this in this one, I can able to execute it. I will write a small program just for displaying natural numbers. Displaying natural numbers. Let us assign that the initial, the n value is 5. Where you are going to display natural numbers 5 starting from 1 to 5. Okay. Now, let me write a for loop. For, and followed by the iterable variable. This iterator variable is the user defined variable. I can give any variable. Okay. In followed by my range, and I'm supposed to mention that, as I told you that we are having three parameter for range, and among these three parameter only one parameter value is a mandatory one, that is nothing but end value, where this n value number is a end value. Where this number is n value, where your loop will be executed till n minus 1. Clear? And one more thing, in case of for loop, you are supposed to give colon here. And now inside this, I am going to do only one simple operation where I am going to print my I value. I hope so you are clear. Just I am initializing my number as 5. And this program is nothing but displaying natural numbers for I in range of number. This number is treated as a end value. End value is nothing but we are having three parameter for range: start value, end value, step value. Among these three parameter, where end value is a mandatory one, so end value is given as number. So 5 is substituted here, and for each and every iteration I'm going to access this I variable. So how does it execute? Initially, if the value is not given, it take from 0. So first it will be iterating with the range value. The range value taken for it is starting with 0 to 5 minus 1, it will be executed. So first 0 will be supplied as a parameter. So 0 will be printed, next 1, next 2, next 3, it goes on. Let me execute it. Now I hope so you are clear with this example. So what happens here? I am going to start with 0. Whenever the range value is not given, start with 0. And next it itself take care of its iteration. It goes to next value as 1, next value as 2, next value as 3, next value as 4. Since your step value is not given, it is taken such a way. Let us assume I have given my start value as 1. Clear? Now let me execute this code and check it, what is the output you are getting. When the start value is given as 1, the same program is starting with value 1. Let us assume I am giving a step value as 2. Starting with 1, step value is 2, and your end value is 15. So now let me execute it. So what could be the answer? First it will start with the value 1, and follow my step value will be 2. So step value 2, in the sense, what happens here? 1 followed by 2 value will be step. So 2, 3 will be printed, next 5, next 7, next 9, next 11, next 13. Next value will be 15. Since this execute till n minus 1, this 15 will not be considered. So it will be accessed only till 14. I hope so you are clear with this for loop. So whenever you are using for loop, I can use 3 parameter for this as a range. Among this, one is a mandatory one where the n value is mandatory. Okay, we have seen one example for this. Where does this else part works? Let us see one more example along with else. We will take a small program where finding given number is a prime or not. Where given number is prime or not. So whenever I name it prime, which number is known as prime number? I will take an example as 7. Whenever I name this 7, 7 is a prime number. How I am saying it is a prime number? 7 has only 2 factor. 1 is 1 and 7. Take a factor of this number. This number will have, whenever it has a 2 factor, then it's a prime number. Let me take some other example. Let me take 6. So factor of 6 is 1, 2, 3. Then the same number 6. And let me take one more number, 10. Factor of 10 is 1, 2, 5, 10. These are the factors of 10. So we are going to check, whenever a number has only 2 factor, then the number is called prime number. This is the logic for it. Now let us start executing program for it. So let me assign my n value as 7. Okay. Now let me start my iteration for I in range. Here I can take a range. I can have a multiple condition for it. Either you can start from 1 to n number and I'm check whether it is having 2 factors. I can check it. Or I can take from 2 to n minus 1. Whenever it doesn't have a factor, I can name it as a prime number. I can go with any logic. Here I am going to the logic where I am going to start with 2, and instead of going till n minus 1, I can go till n divide by 2, which is nothing but I can go till only half of it. It is not required to go till n minus 1. The reason is, whenever you are finding a factor for a given number, the number has only half of its number of a factor. If we take 6 as a number, it will have only factor till 3. Then it will have a same number of a factor. And whenever you take 10 as a given number, 10 will have factors only till 5. It will not have, after 5, no factors will be there. Then the given number is going to be a factor. So, whenever you are going to check a prime number, no need of going till n or n minus 1. It is more than enough to check till n by 2. There is one more optimized method to check the prime number. I will let you know in the forthcoming session. Now I hope so you are clear why I am taking this range of value. Now what I am going to check is, I am going to check where the given number is divisible by the number what I have taken. If the number is divisible, I will print immediately it is not prime. The reason is, I have taken a range only from the between range. I am not taking the given number. I am not taking my range starting from 1. I am not including the given number also. So, the number should not be divisible. It should not have any factor in between. So, whenever it is divisible within the range, then I can say that it is not a prime number. And I can terminate immediately, no need of checking further iteration. If you want to give immediate termination, I can use this break. So what happens whenever you are using break, immediately it terminates. And in case my program executes till the end, it does not satisfy this if condition, so what should be printed there? Then the particular number will be a prime number. I hope so you are clear with this prime number logic. It is so simple. I have taken range from 2 to n by 2. I have given a reason why I am taking n by 2. Whatever the number you are taking, it will have factors only till half of it. It will not have a factor than its half. That is the reason I am taking only till half of it as my range. And the number should not be divisible starting from 2 to half of it. Whenever it is not divisible, I can immediately say that it is a prime number. Whenever it is divisible, it is not a prime number. Now let me execute a program. You can find that this value 7 is displayed as a prime number. For this kind of program, you can make use of this else part. Whenever you are writing a same code by using C programming or something else, where a number of lines of coding will be hardly, it will take 15 lines or 20 lines. But in case of Python, it is very optimized way. I can use such a way by writing else part for your for loop. I hope so you are clear with this for loop. And next we will move on to while loop. Whenever I say that while loop is going to be executed the same manner how your for loop execute and same purpose what you are going to execute. The only thing is, depending upon the programming structure, you are going to implement either for loop or while loop. Both are used for executing a set of code for n number of times again until my condition is satisfied. The way of writing your program is going to be varied. Now let us see the syntax of your while loop. Whenever I say syntax of my while loop, it is similar to the other programming language. While followed by the condition, colon, and the statement which you want to be repeated will be written here. This is a one way of writing. The other way of writing is writing while loop along with the else part. This else part for while loop and for loop is the one of the future which is only implementable in Python, which is not in the other programming language. Let us see a small example for this particular while loop. I'll take a example program as finding factorial for a given number. Factorial is nothing but if a number 5 is taken, what could be the result? 1 into 2 into 3 into 4 into 5, which gives 120 should be your result. Hope so you're clear with this. For writing this, we are going to write a program by using while loop. First, we are supposed to initialize a start value. In case of for loop, we had a range, and range has 3 parameters, start, end and step value, where the start value has to be initialized by the user and the end value should be given as a condition for while loop, and where the step value should be given for the user. I hope so you're clear. Let me repeat it once again. Where the start value should be given separately by the user in case of while loop, where the n value should be given as a condition in case of while loop, and step value should be given separately by the user. So what is the start value for a factorial? If you are going to find a factorial of a given number, then it start with the number 1. So start value will be 1. And in order to store my result, let me give one variable called fact and let me initialize it as 1. Now I'm going to write a code and my termination condition is while my I value is less than or equal to my user given value. This is my termination condition. I'm going to move I value starting from 1 to 5 and until I reaches 5, I'm going to execute it. Once it reaches 6, I'm going to terminate it. This is the condition I mentioned here. Here, what is the operation I'm supposed to do? I'm supposed to multiply this I value along with my factorial value. So how does it execute? Initially, my factorial value will be, let me start here. Initially, my I value is 1. So 1 less than or equal to 5 condition will be true. And here, what is the fact value? Fact value is already 1. So 1 into 1 will be there. And for next iteration, you want the step to be moved from 1 to 2. So what you are supposed to? You are supposed to increment by I value as 1. Now what happened? This value will become as 2 here. And for next iteration goes. And 2 less than or equal to 5. My condition is true. And now what happens? Already the fact value is 1. So 1 into 2 will be there. And value will be stored as 2. And for next iteration, it will become as 3. Similarly, it goes on. So after completing all the iteration, once your I value reaches 6, it will be terminator. Now you want this factorial value to be printed. So let me declare as print factorial and followed by my fact value will be displayed. I hope so you are clear with this. Let me execute this code. So you can find out this factorial 120 is printed. Guys, I hope so you are clear with this while loop. Now let me move on to the next one, where whenever you are using this looping statement or conditional statement, you will come across these three words: break, continue, pass. Just now we have seen about break. What happens if you are applying break? Immediate termination occurs. Immediate termination in the sense, the same program. Let me take a small scenario for break and continue. How does break works and how does continue works? Let me erase all those things. This is not required. So let me remove it. And where, what I'm going to do here is, just I'm going to apply one if condition here. I'm going to apply if condition here. Let me check with the indentation. In case of Python, indentation plays a major role. You are supposed to be aware of the indentation for each and every operation. So let me give, if my I value is equal to 3, if I give break and let me print here, how does this program execute actually? First, what happened? Your I value is 0, 0 less than or equal to 5, my condition will be true. It will come inside, I value will become as 1, it will check I is equal to 1, my condition is false, so it will never enter inside this. So 1 will be printed, again it goes up. Again, 1 will be checked with the condition. Again, it will be incremented. It goes on such a way. Clear? Now, let me execute this code. Let us check with what is the output of it. Your output is 1 and 2. This is the output of this particular code. 1, 2. So, how does it execute as 1 and 2? Whenever 3 occurs, it immediately breaks. Whenever break statement is executed, it will come out of this while loop. So, nothing is there outside the while loop. So, my program terminates. Clear? So, if you want for your clarification, let me write one statement: operation completed. Okay, let me give this and let me execute. You can see that 1, 2, operation completed is being displayed here. So, which after, when 3 is executed, when I value reaches 3, it immediately breaks, it comes out of the loop. This is how your break works. The same case, whenever I give and continue, what happens there? It will take my control back to my loop. Here, back to my loop in the sense, here let me change my break as continue. Okay, so what could be the answer of this? Now, let me check. So, you can notice that your answer is displayed here, where 1, 2, 3 is skipped. So what happens when 3 is condition is true? Here continue will be executed. When continue is executed, it will never allow I value to be printed. It will take my control back here. Again my value will be incremented. Now it will be goes on with the next value. Clear? Until my termination condition, I value becomes 5. So So whenever I value is 5, it will be the last printed value will be 6. After this, the program terminates normally by end of this condition. Then it displays operation completed. Hope so I clear with the for and for while and how to use break and how to use continue. And the last statement is pass. Pass is nothing but nothing. Thus nothing is known as pass. So how where I can use this pass? You can notice that here I give an if condition. Whenever I give if, it should have some body for my if statement. Okay, if statement body should be there. If I'm trying to execute a program, it will throw me an error. Here typo error is there. Let me modify it. It will throw me an error that there is no statement body for my if. So in those cases, some if condition or while loop is given or some function is defined. Right now nothing is there. You can mention pass there. So it does nothing. It will take just some statement for this condition. Your program executes, it goes infinitely. Clear? The reason is I didn't give any condition here. Actually, it should be given here as number. While you're modifying, it has been done. That's the reason. Just a minute. There is some typo error in the program. Let me modify it 1, 3. Okay. Now let us execute. Hope so you're clear. Whenever pass is given, it does nothing. Where it, your normal operation executes, where this I value 3 condition satisfies, but nothing is being printed. The value, nothing is being done. So what happens? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 will be printed, then followed by the operation completed. Guys, I hope so you're clear with all those keywords and how to use it. If at all you like this video, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Click the bell icon. If at all you have any queries, just comment it. I'll explain to it. Thank you.